Well, hello everybody. It's Annie again from Fresh Flair Furniture Artistry. We have something really old today. This will be an interesting one, a little bit challenging because I don't do phonograph and I don't do restoration. So if you're here to see something restored back to its original beauty, you might want to go watch a different video. But this one is a Columbia Viva Tonal Model 710 phonograph. It's circa 1926. It's a crank type, wind up, non-electric record player. And this is what it looked like when I got it back to the shop. I was told that it didn't work, but you'll see that we got it working. This is the back of it. This is like a wooden speaker. And everything in here is all wooden, except, of course, the motor, which is metal. And here's what we were looking at from the very beginning. You'll see this terrible finish on the arm of the record arm, where it holds the needle. But I thought, well, let's see, what should we do to get this started? So I took it all apart with the help of my friend Cliff, and it pretty much sat in this stack of pieces for several months. We didn't know what to do with it, and I think there was a lot of kind of concern about whether we could get it going again or not. But we threw all the pieces in a box, and then we forgot about it until we were ready to focus. The neat thing was that we got some records with it, some waltzes by Guy Lombardo and some other music. And so the day came, and it was time to take this thing apart, every little piece, the hinges and everything. It smelled pretty bad, like somebody had poured gasoline on it or something. But we got it all apart. And as you can see here in these next few photos, I found these pictures on the internet and I borrowed them to show you a little bit about what it might have looked like back in its day. Of course, this picture here is so beautiful and perfect. So if you think it's going to look like this when it's done, I'm sorry, it's not, but it's going to look great. So I started taking the pieces one by one and looking them over. And this is the kind of finish I found on very much of it. This is all a veneer, and it was scratched, dented, chipped, loose, or oxidized, and it was just not in its greatest condition. I sanded this particular piece, and as you can see, it came out pretty well. There's always seems to be some sort of inconsistency in the mahogany when I work on mahogany veneer, especially when it's been really old like this. This is the front piece that comes down. You can open it up like a drop-down cabinet, and then it slides in underneath the speaker, and it's the volume control on the front of the phonograph. And you'll see how that works too. So I scraped off some of it and I thought, well, this might turn out really nice. So put some of the stripper on there, worked it in, let it sit a while, and then I scraped it off. And some of the things about using stripper that's kind of hard is cleaning it up off after you're done. Not just scraping it off, but getting all of the residue, the leftover, let's say varnish, whatever's on there, stains and so forth. So it takes quite a bit of work, but I have this getting cleaned up pretty well with some really fine steel wool and some denatured alcohol. And as we can see it when it's all done, you'll see that it's got that blotchy look that I was talking about. Now here's some of the smaller pieces that I went ahead and stripped as well. Most of this just took time and effort and cleaning up, and it was a messy, messy job. So we got all the pieces, I got all the pieces cleaned up, and then it was sanded and we put it back together. It took the two of us. We probably could have used another person. We went ahead and had to put the puzzle together, remembering how we took it apart, which wasn't easy, but it was a definite puzzle that fit, and with a lot of help of some clamps and glue and patience, we got it all back together. And then it was ready to go to the next step. Meantime, Cliff worked on the motor and got it working. And the neat thing was, is we tried it. That was our very first attempt.
That the brotherhood of man shall bring peace on earth, that all men shall be free, and the people sing.
It's really loud. Because there's no front or back on it at this point. And finally, we realized that the needles that you use, when you get them, you buy them in packages of 100. They come in soft, medium, and loud. Of course, we didn't know what that meant, but we realized medium was probably better. So here's some more pieces. And we started putting it back together little by little. There was some missing veneer on one side of it. This is the back going back together. The sides are all blotchy still. And I'm not sure yet how I'm going to make this look decent. But we replaced that veneer on the bottom there. I taped out the top and painted that. Left some of the natural wood. And just ended up doing what I could to it. And here it is again, and here it is finished. I ended up painting quite a bit of it with a really, really dark plum color. Almost looks brown. I used some of the green and gold that I found in the original piece. The top was severely damaged, so I ended up putting some paint on top and then doing a texture. I don't have a full picture of the top, but I don't know why. I found a little transfer, put it on the front. And here's a photograph of the inside of the cabinets with some peel and stick wallpaper. This is the new cover for the speaker. And this is what it looks like all opened up. The inside turned out really well. I was able to keep some of that wood natural. The arm, the record player needle holder thing, that got all shined up. New felt. The sides there, you can see that dark plum. The crank had copper on it in some spots. We kept that. and just pretty much tried to make it look sort of sophisticated. So if you stay here, you can listen to a little bit of what it sounds like. I hope you like this. It's really different for me. Thank you again for watching. I'll see you next time.